All right, so as you probably know, over the past year or so, Microsoft has been making some pretty incredible strides integrating artificial intelligence into tools like Power BI. Now, some of these tools like Azure machine learning models or sentiment analysis or text analytics are currently only available to enterprise or premium capacity users, but the good news is that there are some great AI tools that are accessible to free or pro users as well. So what I want to do here is cover some of the AI-driven visuals that were recently introduced to Power BI Desktop. Now, important note, what you're looking at here is the December 2019 release. Make sure you've got a current version of Power BI so that you see these new visuals. If you're not sure, head to the upper left corner, jump into Help, About, and you should see the version number. So I'm on 2.7.6, which is the December 2019 release. Now, the first AI visual I want to talk about is the Q&A visual, which looks like a little call-out box or text box here. You'll see a little light bulb in the lower right corner. There are three visuals here that I'm showing with that light bulb. That indicates that it's an AI visual. So we're going to use our VentureWorks report here that we built throughout the course. Let's go ahead and clear this filter on our fields. Just want to work with a data model that we're already comfortable and familiar with. So first things first, we're going to add a new tab or page. Let's call it Q&A, nothing fancy. And here we go. We've got our blank canvas. There are two ways we can insert a Q&A visual. Click the button just like any other chart. Or if you go to the home menu, you'll see an ask a question option, which does the exact same thing. So let's go ahead and delete that duplicate. We can drag this out because this is the only thing we're going to be showing here. And the first thing you'll probably notice is that we have a question bar here, and some suggestions to get started. So Microsoft is looking at our data model and offering some suggestions, things I might want to look at. So total cost by SKU category, total revenue by SKU category, top genders by year to date. You can show some more to kind of get a full list. Now, listen, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I very rarely will use these suggestions. They kind of feel like a shot in the dark. Sometimes you'll get some interesting suggestions, but in this case, we're not that interested in the SKU category. Some of these are just a little weird, like day of week over time. That really doesn't make much sense. But if you click on one, you can see kind of how this visual works, right? It populates the query, turns that query into a visual. And because this is an AI visual, you're not going to get the same chart type every time. Power BI is going to look at your query. It's going to interpret what you're asking and what you're looking for, and it's going to render the most appropriate visual to answer that question. So here we're looking at SKU category with total profit as our values. So let's go ahead and clear that out and ask a question of our own. Now what's important here is that we want to be able to ask a question the same way that we would speak to a friend, right? This visual wouldn't be very powerful or useful if we had to type the same way that we create a DAX measure, for instance, write things like AW underscore sales bracket. That's not natural language. That's not a natural query. So what we can do here is type the same way that we would speak, right? So maybe we want something like revenue by category, press enter. We got a result. Granted, it's maybe not the one that we want, but Power BI recognized keywords in the query, which it underlined in blue, and it took a stab at rendering what it thinks we're looking for. So SKU category, and I can see with the tooltip that it is showing adjusted revenue. Not quite what we want here. But the good news is we can click on that keyword and we can use a different suggestion. So in this case, we want total revenue, and instead of SKU category, we want the product category name. There we go. Now we get something a little bit more reasonable, right? We get bikes, accessories, clothing. And based on the tooltip, we're looking at that total revenue measure. So that looks great. Now, Power BI is pretty smart when it comes to this visual. So let's say that I was typing very quickly and I did something like this. Revenue by category name. Well, it gave me the correct results, same view that we just showed. And now what it's done is underlined that first term, revenue, in red, and it's saying, hey, we think you're probably trying to type revenue here. So we're going to show you the results for revenue by category name. Just like Google does, the autocorrect tool, Power BI is driven by, obviously, AI behind the scenes. And as part of that AI, it understands synonyms and corrections, just like the one we're looking at here. So again, I can click in and I can say, yep, you know what? I want total revenue by category name. And boom, we're off and running. Now, this is really just scratching the surface of what this visual is capable of. You know, this is a simple query, one measure, one column or dimension name. We can get a little bit more sophisticated than this. And we could do something like total revenue for red bikes. Okay. And because this query is designed to aggregate values to a single result, Power BI has displayed the answer or the result in the form of a card, one value, 4.87 million. If you're not sure, if you don't trust that that's right, we can go ahead and test that. We can add a card ourselves. Let's expand our filters. And in this card, we want to show that total revenue measure. And we want to filter it down for the bike category. There we go. And for the color, the product color, red. 4.87 million, boom, there we go. The Q&A visual did its job. It returned the proper result, which is actually pretty impressive when you consider the complexity of this query. We're looking for a measure, aggregated values, based on an attribute, red, which is a value in a dimension from one table, the product table, and also category equals bikes, which is a dimension from a second table, the product category table. So the fact that Power BI was able to interpret that instantly and render the proper result is actually pretty incredible. Now, we can take this a step further. Beauty of AI and machine learning is that you can train these models and train these tools to get smarter over time. So let me show you what that looks like. I'm going to click this gear icon here. This is going to open up this menu. Granted, this is a brand new visual. Things are changing and evolving, so you might not see this exact view. But basically, I've got three options here. I can review questions that have been asked in this visual. I can teach the Q&A visual to get smarter and understand new synonyms. And I can manage any custom terms or synonyms that I've defined. If you click this link here, you'll go to the official Microsoft documentation if you want to dig a little bit deeper. But let me show you how this works. Now, if I click review questions, I'm going to see a list of questions that have been asked in this visual. Now, you won't see any questions here if you've only interacted with the visual in Power BI Desktop. In order for this to work, you have to publish this to a workspace in the Power BI service environment, which we do cover in a separate course, publishing to Power BI service. So as a test, what I've done is upload or publish this report to a workspace in the service environment. I asked a bunch of questions inside of this visual, and they populated right here. So the important thing to note on this tab or this view is that any query that has a red underline or a keyword that Power BI didn't understand has this pencil icon where it says fix needed. And when I click that icon, it takes me to the Teach Q&A tab. It populates that query. And when I hit submit, what it's going to do is show me a preview of what the Q&A visual would return here on the right side. So in this case, a card with the value 24.91 million. And it also lets me define the term in red, the term that Power BI wasn't able to interpret. So in this case, you know, I'm looking for product type, which isn't actually a column name or a field in my model. But I know that this user, because it was me, is actually looking for the category, right? Bikes, clothing, accessories. So what I can do is tell Power BI, hey, whenever you see someone type product type, what they really mean is category name. Okay, so I've just defined a new synonym, and watch this preview update. Boom, there you go. So now instead of the card, it's showing that bar chart with the breakdown by category name. So when I save that synonym, I've now made this visual smarter, and I can manage any terms that I've created right here in that last tab. So pretty cool stuff. If I close out of that dialog box now, and I head into our model tab, you'll see this kind of populate one other place, which is in the properties tab. So if we look at the category name inside of our category lookup table, there's this box called synonyms. Check it out. category name no space, category, and product type, which is the one that we just defined in the Q&A visual. So pretty cool stuff, pretty user-friendly. One last query that I want to show you. Let's say we do something like orders by order quantity. In this case, Power BI interpreted this as a line chart, but really we're not showing anything in a time series. We don't really want a line chart here. I think a bar or column chart would be a little bit more appropriate. So what we can do is convert this to a visual using this button here. Just turns it right into a line chart, and all we need to do is click, and we can modify it, change the chart type, we can format this, we can filter it any way that we like, just like any other visual. So there you have it, pretty powerful stuff. That's the AI-driven Q&A visual.